Parliament's Committee on Commissions, Statutory Authorities and State Enterprises was meant to meet the Minister of Finance today on attempts by the government to negotiate afresh with China the unfavorable conditions in the $200 million loan for the expansion of Entebbe International Airport. Committee members waited for over 1 hour and Kasaija was a no-show.
I've been making calls all through this morning, spoken to his PA, I called his phone, it's the bodyguard that picked, said, I know he's in another meeting. And after that, he's going for another. He will not be able to show up for the COSASE meeting, that he's not ready. You know, that's what the PA was saying. But what do you mean you're not ready? You're the minister in charge, so you must be ready. So when you say you're not ready, what exactly do you mean?
After failing to connect to the minister after several attempts, the committee invoked powers enshrined in Article 90, Clause 4 of the Constitution of Uganda, demanding that the minister appears before COSASE without fail.
We are now going to summon the minister. We had invited him, and the letter we had written was an invitation letter. But when you decide to snub the committee, then we engage another gear because we have powers to do that. So now we are going to summon him using the powers that we have, the powers of the High Court. Because we must be able to get to the bottom of this. Ugandans out there are very worried. You know, sir, you saw some of them saying our airport is taken and so on.
COSASE is currently investigating alleged irregularities in the loan agreement that saw Exim Bank of China lend Uganda $200 million, which is about 708.9 billion shillings. Kasaija signed the controversial loan agreement, which caused a stir after claims that it was exposing Uganda's only international airport to take over by China. The government and Chinese ambassador Zhang Lizong yesterday made it clear that the airport was in no danger of being taken over by China and that the allegations are just not true.
It's a misunderstanding of the agreement between Exim Bank and the Uganda side. This agreement is actually based, guaranteed by sovereign credit, not by the assets or any assets, including the airport. So it's a misunderstanding of this agreement.
Senyonyi emphasized the need to get answers so as to clear any skepticism among Ugandans over the airport.
The way moneylenders operate, they'll give you money, you give them your land title, and they make it complicated for you to pay that loan. And for that matter, they end up taking your land title or whatever it is that you gave as collateral. So that's the challenge we have. With the Chinese, we are happy that they get to help us, you know, with money to do different things, but the terms are problematic, and that's our major concern, and that's why we want the minister to come and reassure the country.
Speaking via a phone interview, Minister Kasaija defended himself, saying the COSASE committee's invitation was on short notice, so he could not appear.
If I get the information late, what do I do?
You got it late.
Yeah.
Yesterday, the Attorney General, Chiriowa Chiwanuka, appeared before COSASE and assured the public that Entebbe Airport is secure.
This contract was signed on 31st March 2015 with a grace period of 7 years. The first payment from Government of Uganda on this contract is supposed to come on 1st April 2022. So, the first payment... Yes, the first payment on this contract is 1st April 2022. So for anyone to say that the airport is being taken because of default is absolutely wrong. It is actually scandalous.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.